Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear beautiful people, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sometimes you look around you, everything is going according to plan. The kids are fine, the house is good, the husband has got a job, nobody is sick, no calamities in life, and everything is going according to plan. And then a small little thought comes into your heart. And you take that for granted. You didn't know you did. But somewhere in the subtleties of your life, a small seed has been planted. That seed is called taking things for granted. And then comes a little time after that, and things start going bad. This happens and that, and then you go to yourself, what has happened into my life? Why are things not going on according to plans? What has changed? Yesterday things were absolutely fantastic. Why have things gone south? And then you start looking for a justification. It could be magic, someone has done magic. Or maybe some jinn, or some black magic or witchcraft. And then you go, no, it could be the evil eye. Maybe bad eye, envy. And you start giving all these justifications and explanations as to what went wrong. But I will tell you what went wrong, my brothers and my sisters. And a lot of people knock down their own empire with the product of their own thoughts. Yusuf alayhi assalam, when he got trialed, and the wife of the prime minister Al-Aziz challenged him in front of women, when she said, either he does what I ask of him, i.e. fornicate, sleep with her, or لَيُسْجَنَنَّ وَيَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الصَّاغِرِينَ, or I will jail him and I will treat him so that he becomes of a really despised and little of value. What did Yusuf alayhi salam say at that time? He said, رَبِّ السِّجْنُ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِمَّا يَدْعُونَنِي إِلَيْهِ. Ya Allah, jail is better for me than that which they ask me for. Straight away Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ. Right after that, Allah answered his wish to be jailed. In the book of At-Tabari, in the tafsir of this particular ayah, he said that Allah told him, Yusuf, had you asked me to safeguard you and take you away from them, I would have. But you asked for the jail, and I gave you the jail. Do you know how many years did Yusuf alayhi salam stay in jail? 10 years. Just because he asked Allah for something he shouldn't have asked for. Yeah. Also, in another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, لَا تَتَمَنَّوا لِقَاءَ الْعَدُوْ. And this hadith is by Al-Bayhaqi, and it's an authentic hadith. Do not wish to meet the enemy. And if you meet him, steadfast. This doesn't go only in fights. Sometimes you are with a sister or a brother, and something happens, for example, her kid gets attacked at school, and you tell her, if this happened to my child, I'd do this. What you don't know is, you have invited a calamity into your life. You didn't need to do that. Why would you hypothesize that if it happened to you, you would do that? Well, you have wished to meet the enemy, just like Yusuf alayhi salam. It's like you say, Ya Allah, put me in her situation and I would do this. After a little time, you fall in that trap. And you face the same situation and then you do or you don't do. Some other times you'll be driving and then you go, I think the road is gonna be a heavy traffic here. And you fall into that heavy traffic. If you didn't say that, Allah could have prevented you from that traffic. Sometimes you have a plate in your hands and you go, I wonder if this plate falls, will it break? And suddenly when you are not paying attention, the plate falls, and I'm sure now you're starting to get the point of what I'm trying to talk to you about. Trust in Allah beautifully. Do not think negative about Allah. He will punish you. Don't think, wallahi, maybe my salat won't be accepted. Well, provided you did everything correct. If you think that Allah might not accept your salat, guess what? Let me hear you say, yes, he will not accept it. If you always accuse Allah of not being the Allah that He accepts what He says, I will, then He will treat you as you did. So the belief in Allah is extremely important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us a story about a people of Saba. Saba is a city in southern of Yemen. These people, they used to live in a beautiful town. Baldatun tayyibatun wa rabbun kareem. Everything was driven to them. They were like advanced in whatever they had in business trades there. When they traveled between cities, it was always populated. But what was the mistake they made? They said, Rabbana, Ya Allah, please put a distance between us and the nearby cities. And they started what? Belittling the gifts of Allah. And when they didn't pay attention, when they least expected, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them all. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, and we made their tale stories to tell, just like I'm telling it to you today. In many times, my brothers and my sisters, Allah tells us things, but we don't read the Quran as receivers. We always read the Quran as a speaker to the other people. It's always talking to the next door neighbor, never to me. A huge mistake. The children of Israel, when they were with Musa alayhi salam in the desert, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treated them to al-man and as-salwa. Al-man is a beautiful bird. And as-salwa is a beautiful sweet fruit. And that is for them. When times for lunch comes in, they get the meat that comes to them, roast them everything. And with it, the dessert. Otherwise, in the desert, there is no way for them to eat. Guess what they did? They looked at Musa and they said, Yeah, Musa, we have had enough of this meat and dessert. Ask your Lord to send us onions, lentils, potatoes, and garlic, and all these things. Musa alayhi salam was so mesmerized and surprised. He goes, Do you exchange this kind of worldly food with that heavenly food? And many of us do that same mistake. You eat on, you put on the table meat and everything, and you cook. But what you don't pay attention is, when you take things for granted, expect punishment. And a lot of times, when you rely on your own abilities and capabilities, that's when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes you. Not because, it's just because you have your PhD that you are guaranteed a job. Absolutely wrong. Many people today, especially in the Muslim world and here, they study, they graduate, and they don't find a job. Why is that? Because they rely on what they got. Yes, you can use what you got, but not as you think you do it. It's not because you have what you have that you're going to get a job, only to find later on that somebody with less qualifications, got the job that you do. My brothers and my sisters, the witchcraft, the sihr, the jinn, the envy, the bad eye, and all these things, it's you who brings them onto you. Many of you think like there is a black magic against you or envy. Well, actually, it's you who has envied yourself. Listen to this hadith of Rasulullah in which he says, إِذَا رَأَى أَحَدُكُمْ شَيْءٌ يُعْجِبُهُ مِنْ نَفْسِهِ فَلْيَقُولْ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ مَا شَاءَ اللَّهِ. Rasulullah pinpoints us to something extremely important. He said, in the meanings of the hadith, whenever one of you sees something in him or his children or his belongings and that he likes, he says, Bismillah, ma sha'Allah. Or you say, ma sha'Allah, la quwwata illa billah. What does this mean? It means, ma sha'Allah, i.e., what I am seeing now, the beauty that I am living in right now, is nothing else but what Allah has willed, and it happened of no efforts of mine, but all of it come from Allah. My brothers and my sisters, if you have problems in your family, review yourself. Perhaps you showed off someday in front of a couple that you were in a good relationship and you didn't thank Allah and praised Allah and acknowledged that gift, Allah punished you. Perhaps when you see your child playing with the kids, you think he's the cutest kid in town, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes you with that. Perhaps. Look at Yusuf alayhi salam. Had he not wanted the jail, Allah could have taken him away, but he chose the jail. So from now on, never ever put yourself in a situation where you say, if I were you, I would have done this. If I was there, I would have done that. If I saw this, I would have said this. If I don't if it. If Allah didn't put you there, it's because you don't deserve to be there. Don't go and punish yourself. Someone says something evil to you in the street and you go, if they said it to me, I would have told them this. And then one day what happens is, somebody's gonna say it to you, because what I'm trying to get to, my brothers and my sisters here, is don't invite trouble to your life. I repeat, do not invite trouble in your life. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, إِذَا رَأَ أَحَدُكُمْ إِنسَانٌ مُبْتَلَى. If you see someone who has been given disease and sickness and things like that, فليقول الحمد لله الذي عافاني مما ابتلاه منه وفضلني على كثير من عباده تفضيلا. When we see someone sick, diseased, poor, broke, lost their job, sickness, homeless, we don't just pass and like totally oblivious. It's like, okay, it's no big deal, it's just no. You want to make a dua at that moment there, because Rasulullah says, if you see someone who is going through hard times, and then or sickness or whatever, and then you make this particular dua, then Allah will not hit you with what He hit him. What is the dua? Alhamdulillah alladhi afana mimma abtala bihi kathira min ibadi. And you have to learn it in Arabic. But in English it means, Alhamdulillah, who has safeguarded me from a lot of what He has trialed others. And that He privileged me by not punishing me or by not giving me what He has given him. And He has made me better than so many other people. At that moment there, when you say this, you acknowledge the bounty of Allah on you, and as such, Allah will not punish you. So from now on, always be sharp. And let me tell you this, wear the lenses, the contact lenses of Tawheed. Look at the world through a small opening called Tawheed. You see the keyhole in the door? You can look through it, right? That keyhole, call it your Tawheed hole. You have to look at everything. When you get to open your eyes in bed at night, don't be totally oblivious and a zombie. Think of it. Allah gave you life at that moment there. Why? Perhaps you have something in your heart that you want to ask Allah. And that moment there, Allah gives you life. It's telling you indirectly, get up now, go make wudu and do two rakat and ask me for that thing. I will give it to you. Do you know how many opportunities we miss? Tons. So from now on, avoid calling troubles to yourself. Don't wish you were in the place of someone else. If the police stops the other one, don't tell them, if I were there, I would have said, because you can rest assured Allah will put you in that situation. You just forget that, but Allah will not forget that. So I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that from now on, we're going to stop this idea, black eye against me, envy against me, and this nonsense against you, or this magic against you. All this is nonsense. Well, it does exist, but the way you're thinking is a nonsense, because in most cases, it's you who is the enemy of you. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you the most beautiful of days. Please pay attention to the words that come from your mouth and the thoughts that you have in your heart. They need to always go through the keyhole of a tawheed. Otherwise, watch out of how your life will degrade and go down south, and you'll wonder why it has happened to me. Now you do know why. Again, this is your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. You guys have an awesome, wonderful day. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us all look through the lenses of At-Tawheed. Telephone number 078-7640-8735. You guys have a wonderful day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.